Hello everyone, welcome back to the session of material science. Myself Rahul Mane, I am working as an assistant professor in the Department of Electrical Engineering, KK Wagh Institute of Engineering Education and Research, Nasik. Today I will discuss unit number 2, that is testing of materials. So learning outcome for the sessions are: at the end of this session, learner will be able to test solid insulating materials, and after testing one can determine the breakdown strength of solid insulating materials. So obviously some prerequisites for the sessions are breakdown strength, then breakdown voltage and some properties of solid insulating materials. So first point, that is measurement of dielectric strength of solid insulating material according to IS, that is 2584. So first of all, let's understand the meaning of insulating material and dielectric material. So what is insulating material? So insulating materials are those which are not able to store a charge, means they are used to provide a perfect insulation, or they are provide us safety from the conducting material. Whereas dielectric materials are those which are able to store some amount of charge in between them. Means from this I can say all dielectric materials are insulating material, but all insulating materials are not dielectrics. Okay, so that is the basic difference between insulating and dielectric material. Now we can classify the insulating material based on their physical state as solid insulating material, liquid insulating material and gaseous insulating material. So here some in general applications are stated regarding the insulating material, and at the last again we will discuss in detail that which are the different applications of solid insulating material. Okay, so in general I can say insulating materials are used in electrical circuit and devices for insulating the conductors from each other or from the earth, as well as insulating materials are used to provide the support to the conducting parts. Okay, so these are the some general applications of solid insulating materials. Now in short we will discuss the different properties of solid insulating material. So first property is that low dielectric loss. So already we are aware about the dielectric loss. So what is dielectric loss? So dielectric loss is nothing but conversion of electrical energy into heat energy inside a dielectric material. That is nothing but dielectric loss. And the dielectric loss should be low in case of solid dielectrics or solid insulating material. Next property is high mechanical strength of the solid insulating material. So next, it should be free from gaseous inclusive or moisture. So obviously if I am using some insulating material over the conducting part, then it should be free from moisture's content, as well as it should be free from some gaseous inclusives. So if there is a presence of some moisture content, then that solid insulating material is not able to provide a proper insulation. That's why it should be free from the moisture. Next, resistance to thermal and chemical deterioration. Obviously, if I am using some insulating material, then it should be resistive to the thermal and chemical deterioration properties. Next property, that is high resistivity to reduce leakage current. So if I am having some insulating material which is provided over the conducting part, then there is some amount of leakage current which is radially flowing outward in direction, and the function of the insulating material is to suppress that leakage current. So obviously a ideal solid insulating material will suppress or will reduce the leakage current from that conducting part. Next, they should have high dielectric strength. So obviously if an insulating material is having high dielectric strength, then it will be used like a good insulating material. After that, low coefficient of thermal expansion so as to avoid stresses and structural damage. So practically it may happen that due to certain physical conditions, a temperature at a particular point may exceed some beyond range, and in that case that insulating material may start expanding, and which will reduce the insulation properties of that insulating material. So practically there should be low coefficient of thermal expansion of a good insulating material. Next, again, I can classify the insulating material as organic material, inorganic material, and synthetic polymers. So some examples are stated here, that is amber, cotton, paper, wood, rubber, wax, pasteboard. These are the examples of an organic materials. So organic materials are those which are naturally available or they are taken from the trees or plant. So inorganic materials, so some examples of inorganic materials are asbestos, ceramics, glass, okay, and some synthetic which are obtained from some polymerization process. Again, in case of synthetic material, there are two types, one is thermoplastic and another one is thermosetting. So we will have in detail discussion regarding the thermoplastic and thermosetting polymers, and some examples are stated here as a polyethylene as a synthetic polymer and bakelite as a synthetic polymer. So in detail you can read all these examples, and in upcoming unit we will have detailed study on these classifications of the materials. So again, if I am considering some solid insulating material, and here some applications are explained of that solid insulating material. So you can go through this table, that is mica, asbestos, porcelain, bakelite, cotton, paper, and PVC. So in detail here I have explained where I can use the mica as well as where we can use the asbestos. Okay, so again, this part may be discussed in later on or in the next unit, but here we need to focus on the testing of solid insulating material. So we can choose any material for the testing from these given materials. Next, insulating material for an electrical device. So in which equipment, which type of material is used in this table? Means if I am having cable, then I can separate the different insulating materials used in cable, that may be PVC, impregnated paper. Likewise, I can separate the materials or insulating materials which are used in cable. Again, if I am considering the power capacitor, then again I can separate the materials used inside a power capacitor, that may be paper, mineral oil, mica, polyester. Likewise, in this table explained each equipment and different materials used under that electrical equipment. So you can go through this. So let's discuss the next point, that is fundamental breakdown mechanism in case of solid insulating materials. Means how the breakdown will take place in case of solid insulating materials. So first point is intrinsic breakdown. So some electrons are able to move through the lattice factor of that solid insulating material, and that type of breakdown is known as a intrinsic breakdown. Second one is thermal breakdown. So we know that some dielectric loss is taking place inside a insulating material, means some electrical energy is being converted into heat energy, and due to that generated heat, the insulating material may get expand up to certain level, and from that point some electrons are able, or some leakage current is able to flow through that insulating material, and such type of breakdown is nothing but thermal breakdown. Next, breakdown due to internal discharge. So we know that at the time of manufacturing process, some voids or gaps, means it is a manufacturing fault which is present over that insulating material, and as we are applying an electrical pressure to such insulating material, then up to certain or over the certain limit, the electrical pressure may get created on the surface of that insulating material, and if some gaps or voids is present, then leakage current will flow through that gap or voids, and such type of breakdown is nothing but internal discharge type of breakdown. Next breakdown is of electromechanical type breakdown. So electromechanical means what? When we are applying an electric field to an insulating material, then there is a formation of polarization, and when polarization will occur, then there is a deposition of two oppositely charged particles on the electrode, and they are responsible for the breakdown, and such type of breakdown is known as a electromechanical breakdown. Next, electrochemical breakdown. So if there is a presence of some chemicals or an insulating material, then it is responsible for the transfer of electrons, and such type of breakdown is known as a electrochemical breakdown. Next, breakdown due to surface discharge. So we know that on the surface of insulating material, if there is a presence of some moisture or dust content, then they will allow to some extent to pass the electric field through that moisture, and they are helping us to break down of an insulating material. Okay, so such type of breakdown is known as a breakdown due to surface discharge. Okay, so these are the some fundamentals by which breakdown will takes place in case of solid insulating material. Now, how to measure the breakdown strength of a solid insulating material? For that, we are having a procedure. So here we will discuss one step by step the test procedure to conduct the breakdown test on solid insulating material. So first step, test specimen from solid material care should be parallel to the electrode. Means if I am taking one piece of paper and I am trying to find out the breakdown strength of that paper, then that paper should be kept parallel to in between the two electrodes. Next, the area of the test specimen should be sufficient to prevent flashover. Means the size of that paper should be enough which will cover the surface of the electrodes. Next, the electrode should be kept clean and free from pitting caused by an arcing. So every time when I am testing the different materials, then at that time you should clean the surface of electrodes. Next, there should not be any sharp point on the surface of electrode. So obviously take care that the electrodes which are used for the testing purpose, they are smooth in nature. There should not be any pointed surface lying over the surface of electrode which will cause an early breakdown of an solid insulating material. Next, ensure that the test cell is properly connected to the ground. So obviously if we are working on a high voltage, then the test cell should be connected to the ground. Next, place a sheet of insulating material in between the two electrode properly. So obviously as we have discussed in the first point, the test sample should be placed properly in between the two electrodes. Next, switch on the power supply, and after that, next, the voltage shall be raised from zero at a uniform rate such that breakdown will occur. So take care that you are varying the voltage by uniform rate. It may be 2 kV per second. Next, note down the exact values of breakdown voltage, and after reading the breakdown voltage, you can find out the breakdown strength of solid insulating materials. So here some basic diagram is explained here. So first of all, here I am having phase and neutral, and after that you can have ELCB and MCB arrangement, and then I am having auto transformer in order to vary the voltage. Here step up transformer is used. This is the primary side and this is a secondary side in which higher voltage will be present, and here test sample is present, means two electrodes, and in between that this is the test sample. So this is the upper electrode and this is the lower electrode, and in between that one test sample, that may be paper or anything, which is placed in between these two electrodes. Okay, so here you can write down the rating of the transformer used, that which is nothing but 0 to 60 kV, or that is depend on the laboratory setup. Okay, so every lab will have different specifications. So here one simple diagram which will shows us the nature of the test cell, means this total is a lower electrode, this one is a upper electrode, and in between that I can place a test sample. So solid insulating material, that may be paper or piece of paper, which is placed in between these two electrodes, and I can apply the variable voltage, and at a particular point this material may get break, and one can measure the breakdown strength of that solid insulating material. So here some specifications are explained according to IS standard, that is height, length, or what is this length of the upper electrodes and diameter, everything which is given in the IS standard. Okay, so this is the standard diagram from book, and which is can be drawn on the notebook. Next, so this is the ideal circuit diagram. So in previously we have drawn the diagram with the help of pen, and this is from the textbook, and here they have mentioned the ideal test cell. Next, observation table. So after testing the solid insulating material, we have to mention here which type of solid insulating material used, means that may be paper or asbestos or mica sheet. You can name that material here After that, what is the breakdown voltage? That may be 4 kV, 5 kV or 6 kV, anything. So that last breakdown voltage recorded can be written here. And then finally thickness. So we have to measure the thickness of that test sample, and that can be noted down here. So I can mention that maybe 2 mm, 1 mm, 0.5 mm, likewise. So that is depending on the material or which material is used for the testing purpose. And finally, I can calculate the breakdown strength of the material by kV per mm. Means this is the breakdown voltage divided by thickness of that material, which is nothing but breakdown strength of the material. And here you can mention that breakdown strength for each and every material as kV. Next, the different factors which are affecting on the dielectric strength of solid insulating material. So first, thickness of the material. So as there is increase in thickness, breakdown voltage is increasing, but breakdown strength may remains same. Temperature. So if there is increase in temperature, again breakdown voltage may get reduced. Moisture content. So if there is presence of any moisture content on the surface of solid insulating material, then again it will affect on the breakdown voltage. Again, duration of applied voltage, that will affect on the breakdown voltage of solid insulating material. Then composition of the material, means whether the composition is organic, inorganic or synthetic, based on that its breakdown voltage is different for the different type of solid insulating material. And defects of the material. So if there is any voids or gap is present on the surface of that material, which will again affect the breakdown voltage of solid insulating materials. Precautions to be taken while measuring the breakdown strength of a solid insulating material in a lab. So first, zero start switch. So a zero start switch is required to avoid accidental application from a previous set of high voltage while taking a next reading. So before taking the next reading, always ensure that you have used the zero start switch arrangement. Next one is relay setting. So during the breakdown, the short circuit current flows through the winding of the transformer, and to protect the transformer from this heavy current are sensed by the relays, and it will trip the supply. Okay, so that is the importance of relay setting in the measurement of breakdown strength of solid insulating material. Next, electrodes of the test cells should be clean and free from the dust particles while conducting each and every test on different solid insulating materials. Again, there is the importance of safety fuse. So, safety fuse provides us safety of an adequate capacity of the protection from the overload and short circuits. Provision of indication lamp to create awareness. And finally, the pressure on the specimen should not affect the breakdown. Now, conclusion. So, breakdown strength depends on the type of material and composition of insulating material. And next, for the same insulating material, breakdown strength increases with increase in thickness. So already we have seen that different factors which are affecting on the breakdown of solid insulating material, and under that we have discussed the effect of thickness. Means as there is increase in thickness, the breakdown voltage increases with increase in thickness for that insulating material. Okay, thank you.